Mr. Chairman, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you this afternoon our guest and pre-convocation lecturer, a man of acumen personality, a man of integrity, a man of humility, trustworthy, simple, gentle, patriot, and man of gravity. This man is no other person than His Excellency, distinguished Senator Goswill Abbott Apabio, CON, Honorable Minister of Niger Delta, Federal Republic of Nigeria. Mr. Chairman, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, the emergence of His Excellency, Senator Goswill Abbott Apabio, CON, as then the executive governor of Agua Ibom State in 2007, is the most hotly contested election in the history of the state, was a justification of the ancient Italian saying that the right man comes at the right season. He came with an innate passion to help people expand their imagination and maximize their potentials. This passion, coupled with a strong sense of justice and integrity, was inculcated in the childhood and led him to a position of leadership in different stages of his life. Like a coach, destiny had prepared him for impact and influence. Today, and currently, he was found fit by police in the Senate of the Federal Republic of Nigeria to be elected the minority leader in spite of being a first-time senator. And then the governor of Akwa Ibom State, he commenced a revolution in the state which excited the imagination of the people and was aptly described as uncommon transformation. He was widely honored and celebrated within and outside the state because of his great achievements in human and infrastructural development. He has emerged as one of the most honored men in our country today. His visionary leadership style motivated and shaped an entire generation of Akwa Ibom people and became a metaphor for administrative excellence. These attributes led to his re-election to the Senate. Personal details. The son of Chief Abbott Apabio and Madam Lucy Abbott Apabio. Me in Yangato of Okana Eko Induce in ACN Odin local government area, Governor Goswill Apabio was born on December 9, 1962. He lost his father when he was 6 months old and was raised by his mother, who inculcated in him the values of hard work, discipline, and honesty. He was educated at Methodist Primary School Okana, ACN Odim local government area of Akwa Ibom State, the prestigious Federal Government College Port Harcourt River State, and the University of Calabar Cross River State, where he obtained a degree in law. He was called to the bar, Nigerian bar, in 1988. At Federal Government College, his sterling leadership qualities led to his being appointed the General Senior Prefect. In the University of Calabar, his charisma endeared him to the students and he was elected the Speaker of the Students' Parliament. He had a brief stint as a teacher and an associate partner with Paul Osaro and Company, a leading law firm in Nigeria. In 2002, Governor Akpabio rose to the position of the Managing Director / Chief Executive Officer of AMIF Telecoms Limited, a pioneer fixed wireless telecommunications company in Lagos. In this position, he helped in shaping the future of the bourgeoisie telecoms industry. He also served as the National Public Secretary of the Association of Telecommunication Companies in Nigeria, ATCOM, while Director of EMIS. In 2002, he was appointed the Honorable Commissioner for Petroleum and Natural Resources. Between 2002 and 2006, he served as a commissioner in three key ministries: Petroleum and Natural Resources, Local Government and Chieftaincy Affairs, and Lands and Housing. This is because of his indelible imprint of competence and efficiency associated with his leadership. His warm personality, charisma, people skills, humility and integrity led to a mass statewide agitation for him to seek higher office. His governorship bid in 2007 was an anchor on the unselfish premise, let God's will be done. With my support, he defeated 57 aspirants in the hotly contested primary election to emerge the candidate of the People's Democratic Party in 2006. In April 24, 2007, he was elected governor, and in 2011 he was re-elected governor after running a campaign encore on the same slogan, let God's will be done again. At the cap of his second tenure as governor, the people of Northwest Senatorial District prevailed on him to contest election to represent them as a senator of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. He stood for that election on March 28, 2015, and won resoundingly. He is currently the senator-elect of Akwa Ibom, Northwest Senatorial District. He left indelible footprints in the stance of Akwa Ibom time. Such footprints include the free and compulsory education program initiated by the Akpabio administration from primary to secondary school. This has tapped the house help syndrome, which the state was hitherto known for it. It has also helped, in combating kidnapping and other vices by providing proper direction for children in the state. This program, which is codified into law, pays subvention to secondary school principals at 300 naira per student per term, and to primary school head teachers at 100 naira per pupil per term. We are quadruple school enrollment in the state, and over 400 classroom blocks, 4,000 classroom blocks have been built or rehabilitated in 1,183 schools to support the program. Other footprints include the following: free and compulsory education, as mentioned and explained earlier. Education must be free. Completion of Ibom International Airport, which he made a site pillar level and completed the first phase of the airport with a 3.6 kilometer runway. The airport comes with maintenance, repair and overhaul facility, which is under construction. Domestic and international flight operations have since commenced at the airport. Work has completed on the building of the state-of-the-art main terminal building of the airport and another taxiway. So far, the airport has become the fastest growing in the history of aviation in Nigeria. The main administrative block has since been completed. he traveled, he had constructed over 320 new roads, totaling over 1,350 kilometers, including over 200 kilometers of federal roads. Many of these roads are dual carriageways. In fact, these achievements are more than 5 pages. Let me jump to the other subtitle. We improved. You see, Mr. Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, the gentleman before us, when I keep on reading his achievements as far as the development of Akwa Ibom State, it will take us about 2 hours. Let me rise to where he has been honored with honorary doctorate degrees. He has been given so many international honors. Let me mention two. The Congressional Certificate of Revolution of the United States Congress. The national honors. He is the commander of the Order of the Niger, CON. Best Ghana Infrastructure and Empowerment Award of the Central Bank of Nigeria in 2012. Most prolific governor by the National Chancellor's Post. Academy Professional Honors. He was given so many honorary doctorate degrees, honorary courses. By Nigerian Defense Academy. One. Federal University of Technology, Oweri. University of Nigeria, Nsukka. University of Calabar, in Port Harcourt. University of Oyo in Kenya. Namandi Azikiwe University. Adia State University. Wesleyan University of Science and Technology, Ondo. Enugu State University of Science and Technology. Bangkok University, Isharan Reno Ogun State. Of technology, Yawa, but there are more than 40. We were given the collective media honors by Leadership Newspaper, by Sun Newspaper, by Nigerian National Daily Newspaper, Nigerian Tribune Newspaper, Newsday Newspaper, Daily Independent Newspaper, National Daily Newspaper, etc., etc., more than 50. Ladies and gentlemen, our guest lecturer is a Christian of the Catholic faith. He's happily married to the beautiful and amiable Octavio. And the marriage is blessed with four beautiful daughters and a son. He and his wife share a great passion for the underprivileged and for service in humanity. His Excellency Senator Gosset Obadiah Sajjan, through life, appears to have been preordained and convicted for worship and impact. His life is like an emerging radiance, and we have only caught a glimpse of his potential. He is a man at peace with his wife and himself, and who is always looking for ways to be a blessing to humanity, the man by himself.
Friends, Nigerian friends, Asleng. Yodel Papa. Yodel Bosa. Yodel Gigi. I want to speak. I want to sing. I want to appreciate. I want to shout. I want to dance. I want to get you.